Females are the most beautiful and gorgeous creatures in the whole world. And I think that we are gorgeous no matter what size we are. She is the founder of Stories Matter, an organization focused on integrating stories into school curriculum to focus on holistic learning. She conducted several workshops across schools in India and also created digital content. During this pandemic time, she contributed herself by creating video content, conducted online story sessions, webinars, counseling sessions, Facebook Lives, and attended many such events. To name a few, she has conducted sessions for Delhi University, India Today Media Institute, DPS Schools, Manav Rachna International School, and many more. Let me introduce you all to Indu Punj. Over to you, ma'am.
Each time a woman stands up for herself without knowing it possibly, without claiming it, she stands up for all women. This is a famous quote by Maya Angelou. Good evening to one and all. It's my proud privilege to be amongst all the August gathering of esteemed speakers and great dignitaries. I'm highly thankful to all the organizers of YUCI. Sorry, because I was on mute. It's taking me a bit. And after the power-packed session of Dr. Aziza, I'm already feeling little, nervous now. So the facts that she has talked about owning the story, I quite well resonate with the same thought. And being a storyteller, as I am known to be, I teach through stories, I integrate stories in regular curriculum, bringing life skills. And this is what I'm going to do today. I'm bringing you two stories today. One is a fiction and one is a real life story, which we have just seen in recent days. Being a counselor, I give a lot of attention to mental health, as it's been said in my introduction. So for me, if you are mentally agile, mentally healthy, and you can create your own story. And because what Aziza has been talking about, I'm totally 100% in agreement to that, that we have to own our story. Now, my first story is from Rabindranath Tagore's Stree Kapatra. First of all, it's very close to my heart because the story talks about a letter which a wife writes to her husband. And this was written in 1914. And more than 100 years back also, women were facing the same problems as we are facing today. It was a patriarchal society where they were not allowed to raise their voice, where they were not allowed to express their own passions or to pursue them. So here, Mrinal, the protagonist, she talks about her life, how she was brought to this from a poor family to an aristocratic family as a bride, as a bahu of the family. But she was always expected to follow rules and which confided her to live in kitchen or bedroom. Her life was restricted only in these two areas. Her sister-in-law had totally given up on herself and she was abiding by all the rules that were told to her unquestioningly. She was quite okay living that way. But our protagonist, Mrinal, she always raised her voice. She would tell stories. She would feel comfortable in a cow shed. She felt that cows and buffaloes were much more loving, empathetic, and understanding than the members in the family. Though all her basic needs were very nicely met, but she never felt loved. She never felt heard. She never felt her authentic self, which is what we all need as women. As human beings, I would say, we all have it in us that we want to be heard, we want to be seen, we want to be our most authentic self. So today, on this day, in this special event, I want to say, taking this Mrinal story forward, she happens to visit this pilgrimage Jagannath Puri, and standing on the shores of sea, she tells her husband that I refuse to come back. There she finds out, she founds her liberation, that there is much more to life than being living as a Manjali Bahu. She thinks that she can explore life much more. She has much more left in her life to do than just doing those responsibility, discharging her duties as a Bahu, as a household maid, as a wife. And she just takes a stance and sends this through her letter. So there is a movie based on this, which had won this was a national award winner movie, which was made in Bengali. So here, what we learn from her is, like 100 years ago, also Rabindranath Tagore had the vision to talk about patriarchal society and to break those roots of women. Then he had given the power through his words that we have it in us. We are the ones who have to decide. We are the ones who have to own our story. Now coming to my next story, which is we have recently experienced about Rani Rampal's story. In her own words, she wanted an escape from, I would say the story in her words, I wanted an escape from my life, from the electricity shortages of the mosquitoes buzzing in our ear, from barely having two meals to seeing our home getting flooded. There was only so much my parents could do. Papa was a cart puller and Ma was a maid. There was a hockey academy nearby, so I'd spend hours waiting for players I wanted to play. Papa would earn rupees 80 a day, couldn't afford to buy me a stick. Every day I'd ask the coach to teach me. He rejected me, not because he didn't want to train her, because she wasn't strong enough to pull through a practice session. So I began practicing with a broken hockey stick. I used to run around in a salwar kameez, but I was determined. Maine bahut mushkil se convince kiya coach ko, but my family said, hum tumhe skirt aur kameez mein khelne nahi denge. I plead, please mujhe jaane do. If I fail, I do whatever you want. My family gave in. Training would start early. We didn't have a clock, so my mom would look at the sky to check in if it was time to wake up. At the academy, it was mandatory for each and every person to drink at least 500 ml of milk. I couldn't afford that. I would add water just because I didn't want to miss my practices. Finally, I was selected, represented my state, and got at a national level team at 15. Still, relatives would ask me when I was getting married, but Papa said, play until your heart's content. With my family's support, I eventually became the captain of the Indian hockey team. The rest is a history. You all know she's not only brought laurels to herself, but to the entire country. We are all so proud of her. So my dear friends, as Dr. Aziza was saying, take the onus of your story. Be the author of your story. This is what I have recently also written. If we want, there is something which is not as per our aspiration, as per my views, we have the power to change it. We can edit it instead of just scribbling about it. Everybody has talked about laws, empowering women, gender equality. First of all, we have to be the change that we want to see in ourselves or the people around us. If I don't want to, I wouldn't do it. Even if the entire world is changing, if I do not wish to change myself, nobody on this earth can empower me. So we have to first empower ourselves and take the pen, power, the pen of our story in our hands. We shouldn't give that power to anybody else. As I'm coming to end, I will just like to close my speech with Brené Brown's thought. Owning our story can be hard, but not nearly as difficult as spending our lives running from it. Embracing our vulnerabilities is risky, but not nearly as dangerous as giving up on love, belonging, and joy, experiences that make us the most vulnerable. Only when we are brave enough to explore the darkness will we discover the infinite power of our light. Thank you. Thanks a lot for inviting me. This was entirely my pleasure.